Hey guys! In today's video, I wanted to talk about something that has been on my mind lately while we paint together, and maybe you can relate with some of the things I'm about to share with you guys. Now, as you might know, I visited the island Crete in Greece just recently, and it gave me the time to discover and absorb all the history, all the beautiful colors and nature while I was taking some time off. I took a lot of pictures of things that caught my attention. I also realized I do enjoy traveling and learning about new things. And I also discovered a pattern in not only the things that were fun to me, but also in the objects and the colors in those pictures I took. Looking at them brought me so much joy, and I realized that this is something that was missing in the art I was making. I realized I wanted to feel the exact same joy and excitement with my own art. Life gets so stressful sometimes that you just forget to pause for a moment, to reflect and to adjust so you can move on with a better understanding of what and why you're doing something in the first place. You rather get caught up with different tasks and get distracted by all sorts of things that you start doing things for the wrong reasons. And that's something that happened with me as well, I think. I never really took time nor the space to really think through certain things. Since most of the art I made was usually linked to the videos I was making on YouTube, I realized I somehow stopped doing art just for myself. At some point, it was rather the thought of having to post regularly because the algorithm could punish you, paired with the thought of what others would be most interested in seeing. And even though I liked most of the art I created and I cared about it, I was still not fully happy with it for some reason. And for the longest time, I actually couldn't put my finger on it. I was so confused. And now that I took proper time to reflect on this issue I had for months, I realized that I rather painted something I randomly saw on the outside or thought people would like, without feeling anything on the inside. So even though I liked the end result, I didn't feel any connection with the art piece at all. I realized it was usually because I not only chose a topic for the painting that I wasn't fully passionate about, but also because of my color choice and style. So sometimes I felt like the art I created wasn't a representation of who I am anymore. And this is something I discovered only by creating all sorts of different paintings and looking at other people's art and my surrounding to see how I feel about it and to really narrow down what I want from my own art. For me, art was always something that links directly to the artist, how he feels, what he's going through, and what inspires him. And I somehow lost sight of it with my own art. And it definitely wasn't always the case. And I think that's something we all struggle with at some point in our art journey, but we don't fully realize it at first. Even though we know we should make art that makes us happy, we still can't help but fall into the trap of social media and other platforms nowadays. And because of that, we sometimes end up evaluating our artwork depending on some random metrics that decide whether we should be happy or unhappy with our own work. When I was growing up, there was no social media. I just made art for art's sake, and I was focusing on creating something that I truly cared about, that I was passionate about, and was a part of who I am. Now I see a lot of young artists stress so much about getting likes, followers, and change what they do just to increase their popularity. Art stops being a representation of things that moves us, that we love, and that makes us happy, that inspires us. It rather turns into something that makes us feel miserable instead. And I think this played a huge role in my own problem. All these artificial algorithms caused this disconnect between me and my art. So sometimes the first thought I had was, I have to post something. Instead of thinking, I want to create a beautiful art piece I'm super proud of and that reflects my own personality. And for that, I will take my time to create it. This is why I wanted to remind you guys that all the likes and views our work gets on any platform is in no way a reflection neither of how good our work is nor of our self-worth. It shouldn't dictate what art we should and shouldn't create just because something got less engagement than we hoped. Social media always plays by their own rules, and people can be just busy that they simply missed your post. Plus, there are a ton of other factors that we are not in control of. But we are in control of what we're making and how we feel about it. If it brings you pure joy to paint a certain way, to paint certain things while using certain colors, then this should be the main focus, because this will shine through your work. With our art, we want to convey our personality, the things that inspires us, that makes us feel happy to create, and when we decide to, we can then share these feelings with others through our art, and the right people will follow. Art is all about connecting with other people, not feeding a machine. People and algorithms are not the same, so why do we keep constantly forgetting about that? I do believe that all these ups and downs we have to face in our life are important for the learning experience. And sometimes you do just feel a little bit down. It's okay. You can always pause, reflect, adjust, and then move on. It's just important to remind ourselves that making art that truly is part of us will not only make us happy and so much more patient during the process, but it will also make us proud of it, regardless of what others might say or think, because we would know that we fully stand behind it. But at the end of the day, we all want to be happy, and one of the ways to achieve that is to be fully in tune with yourself. By not only knowing yourself really well, but also by aligning your thoughts and beliefs with your actions.